Good morning, everybody. Today I'm going to be talking to you about how to sharpen a knife using an oil stone. Now, this oil stone that I'm using here has got two sides to it. This is the coarse side and this is the fine side. It's an aluminium oxide stone. I don't know if you can see it, but yeah, it's aluminium oxide stone. Very cheap to get at almost all hardware stores or grocery shops or whatever. There's no reason not to have one, and no reason to have a blunt knife. In fact, I mean, these things, you know, if they're so cheap and you know how to use them, you can have sharp knives all over your house. Alright, so what I've done here, just to keep things steady, is I've nailed two nails on each side here to keep the sharpening stone steady as I'm using a sharpening stone. Now, if you don't feel like putting nails on your workbench, or you don't have a workbench to put nails on, you could simply use a plain old rag like this and put the stone on top of it, and it should keep it steady. But I don't know, I prefer these nails. They keep things a little bit more steady. Okay, so this is the knife I'm going to be using. It's just my bait knife that I use for fishing. And I sharpen this knife at a 20 degree angle, roughly 20 degree angle. Now, 20 degrees as an angle for knives is pretty, it's a good angle to use for most knives, for general work. That if you're going to be using a knife for, say, filleting a fish, which is a bit more finer, you're going to have to use a lower angle, which is, or would be about 15 to 17 degrees. And if you're going to be using something like a cleaver, for example, you're gonna be splitting joints and chopping through bones, so you want a bit more of a durable angle. So for a cleaver, I would recommend a 25 to 30 degree angle on each side. Now, on a sharpening stone, you don't have much of an indication of what angle you're going to be using, so it's all sort of by feel. Now, if you are unsure of what angle to use, or how to make your angle, or how to see what your angle is, you can simply take a piece of paper, fold it in a 45 degree angle. Like that, fold it again, which makes a 22 and a half degree angle, roughly. Now, I'm doing this quite rough, so it's probably not quite there. After that, you can cut this section off here. Set it on your sharpening stone. And that will be 22 and a half degrees. Now, for this bait knife, I tend to go a little bit shallower, just to make it a 20 degree angle. And you can use that. It's pretty useful. So, with an oil stone, you obviously need to use oil. I use this mineral oil. It's cheap, it's readily available, and it works. I mean, you don't need to get too serious about what oil you use. I mean, they probably all work. Right, so when you're starting, put a good amount of oil there, rub it in. Now, do note that this sharpening stone is quite new, so it's quite dry as well, so you're gonna have to use more oil if it's a new sharpening stone. As a sharpening stone gets older and more used, you'll require less and less oil because it's constantly saturated. Right, so when you're sharpening a knife, use two hands to hold one at the handle, one on the back of the blade, and stroke going forward, not back. A lot of people think that you should stroke backwards on a sharpening stone. That's wrong. Well, I suppose you could do it, but you won't get as nice of an edge as if you would stroke forward. So, just to prove that I'm going to be sharpening this knife, I'm going to be taking a plain old file, and you're going to cringe hearing this. I'm going to blunten up the knife nicely. That should be very blunt. And doesn't cut paper, right? Doesn't cut paper, and it definitely won't shave my hair on my arm. So, oil soaked in nicely over here, and set your knife at about a 20 degree angle and stroke going forward 10 times on one side, 9 on the other, 7, 6, 5, so and such, right down to 1. After you complete it, after you've done that, you swap it over on the fine side and do the same thing, 10, 9, 8, 7, so and such. Right, so I've already done one stroke there. So, that was 9 strokes, but I did an extra just to show you. Now if you miss, if you do an extra stroke more, you miss one, it's not a big deal. I mean, in the end, the knife won't be any more sharper or blunter than it, you know, once you're done. But generally keep to the thing of the way of 10, 9, so and such. You know, 10, 9, 8, 7, so and such. It works. 8 on this side. Okay, there's one. And you swap it over, go onto the fine side. And you get this thing set properly. That's 10. Sometimes I lose count, and excuse me if I have lost count in this video. I'm only human. I tend to get in almost a trance while I'm sharpening my knife, so I tend to forget what number I'm on. But yeah, it's generally there. I'll just do an extra couple of light strokes once I'm done with that. One. Just to get the edge a little bit finer. That should be alright. Alright, now this edge should be sharp enough to cut paper. Ah, not so much, eh? There we go. See, that is sharp. And I should be able to shave the hairs on my arm. You see the hairs here? Now, this edge is quite fine, but if you want to get it even finer, you can use a strop. Now, this is a plain old piece of leather that I got from an old belt that I had. Took a piece of pine wood and just carved out this strop and stuck this on with some rubber glue. It's no big deal, and they work well. Now this is just to give you that fine, scary edge, you know, that like sort of pops hairs off your arms without even touching, you know. Hair sort of just gets scared off in a way before it gets even touched. So to do this is the only time when you should stroke a knife backwards, not forwards. If you stroke forward, you're going to cut into the leather and ruin your strop. So you want to hear it like whisper. You don't need to push too hard, but firmly. And there's no real set count of how many times you need to stroke the knife, but it's all about feel. And I mean, I've been using this method for a long time, and you know, when I feel the knife is ready to come off the strop. You can actually go into a trance doing this. This is so relaxing. And when you start ending off, just go lightly, lightly over, barely putting any pressure on the blade. And make sure you do the whole edge. And then that's it. You're done. You sharpen a knife. Right, so now this edge should be extremely sharp. You can see that my hair is just flying off. Alright. I'm gonna paper test. Right, so I mean that's actually almost too sharp for a bait knife, because bait knives get really abused on the boat or wherever while you're fishing. But I mean, this method can be used for any knife that you have. Bearing in mind though, if you have a very short knife, say, I don't know, a small pocket knife or something like that, the blades can be a little bit too small for you to hold them with two hands. So you can get away with holding on by one hand. Just keeping in mind, don't put your hand in front of the path of the blade. And sorry if there are a couple of hiccups in this video. Nothing really always works perfectly. But thanks for watching. I hope I've taught you something. Cheers.